All right, guys, makeup sharing. We have almost a full face of Shantikai to share with you. And for this video, there were 5 items that were sent to me from Skin Store. I picked the items myself, and all the other items, makeup, skincare, etc., were all purchased by me or were already in my collection. So you'll recognize some and some things are new. But this is to kind of bring attention to the Black Friday sale they're having. All the items I talk about will be anywhere from 20 to 30% off, and I have a code for you that will give you an additional 10. So that's really exciting. I don't get anything like from that code. That's just so the tracking link, that's what I mean. I mean, we're still gonna have the other things. We're gonna have food sharing. I have a really fun item from Amazon to share with you. I have 2 bases from Shantikai. These are both items I picked off of the Skin Store website, and I will like asterisk everything in the description box below so you know what was sent to me. I have the Shantikai Future Skin in the shade Chamomile. This is a very light coverage. In a clip later in the video, I have this on while I'm talking about Obagi and Derma Doctor. You'll see in that like, you know, whole clip where I'm talking, the skin looks really beautiful, but it doesn't cover any of the like dark spots that I have. It doesn't really hide any kind of like texture. It doesn't do any of those things, but it is a really beautiful, healthy looking foundation. The other complexion item I have is the Just Skin Tinted Moisturizer. This has an SPF of 15, and I have it in the shade Vanilla. It's what I have on today. The tinted moisturizer actually has more coverage than the foundation. So that is the Future Gel, and that is the Just Skin Tinted. The Just Skin Tinted is a little more brightening on my skin, and the gel foundation kind of just like blends in, and it leaves kind of just like a skin-like finish. So this tinted moisturizer, I've applied it with a brush and I've applied it with a sponge before. I don't get more coverage out of either method, but when I kind of apply this to my skin, I'll squeeze a little bit out, I'll like, you know, put it on like a good amount of my skin with my finger, and if I let it sit for like 30 seconds and then go in with the sponge, I do get more coverage. For concealer, I have the Rodial Diamond Concealer. I have it in the shade 20 and I have it in the shade 30. So 20 is on my under eyes. When I apply this, I apply it to my hand, the back of my hand, and I let it sit for a little bit, and then I go in with a little sponge and I apply it on my under eye, starting from the outside in, so that I get the most product out here and the least amount of product in here. Even though this is the part where I need the most coverage, I prefer less concealer, just so it kind of lightens it a little bit, but I'm not trying to do full coverage, because when I do full coverage in that part of my eye, it shows, like it's cakey. You can see the creasing. Maybe cakey is the wrong word, it's a strong word. You can see the little creasing and the little fine lines. So the 20 is on my under eyes and the 30 is on my face. I set the face with the Rodial Banana Powder. This is a more mattifying powder, but it is brightening. So I ran it through my brows today because I noticed how mattifying it has been when I've been using it. And not mattifying in that it will be dry, just mattifying in that there is no glow. So I ran it through my brows today, so let me know. Let me know if my brows look even remotely less shiny than usual, because this is the Shantikai Ultra Sun Protection Sunscreen Broad Spectrum SPF 45 Primer. This is another item that I chose to have sent to me for review. An incredibly, incredibly moisturizing primer, and the fact that it has SPF 45 is even better. So it is a very watery slash, I don't want to say oily, but watery and viscous type primer. You can feel it holding the moisture in your skin. I also think there is a ball in there, because when I shake it, I can hear it, so it helps it mix together. The first time I used it, I did not shake it up. So I was like, oh, this is like very watery. And then I shook it up and it was still quite liquidy and quite fluid. So just know that going in, but that means a little goes a long way. So this will last you quite some time. You could even potentially use this, depending on your skin type, the season where you live and where you live. This could just be your moisturizer. You don't need to double up. It is very, very hydrating. You can see it's like already running. It is a very, very, very glowy primer, but it does settle. I thought I would just look really glowy for the rest of the day, But once I like blended it in and I applied, you know, foundation on top of it, it just looked like normal skin. It wasn't like particularly glowy. The Rodale Instaglam Highlighting Powder. I have this on the heights of my cheekbones, which, do you see how naturally beautiful we are looking? Like, this is not something that shows your texture. It is a very thin, lightweight concealer. And for a powder, it's very, I don't know if I want to use the word unique, but you can see it there. It has more of that lit from within glow, similar to their low lighter, the Banana Low Lighter. I don't have the full size. I have this like little mini, but there's still 2.5 grams of product and I don't know that I'm ever gonna go through it. The bronzer I have on is the Goa. It's this shade. This is not like new. I've talked about this a lot. This was like the only bronzer I used for a really long time. I could easily say there was like 2 to 3 months where I used only this, and then I like slowly moved away from it. Like if you looked at my description box, it was always this. Like this one has been very well loved. We've used up all of the like pretty embossing. The mirror is dirty because I tap my brush into there. Goa is a reddish brown undertone and Serena is your standard classic bronzer shade. So Goa and Serena. I have Goa on quite heavily today. For the eye makeup, I have the Chantecaille Compact Soleil Bronzer in the shade Tahiti, and I have it all around the crease and the lower lash line, and I just kept using it as a blending shade. My favorite eyeshadows from Chantecaille, I think, yes, I'll say these for sure, are the luminescent eyeshadows. They are a little pricey, so the fact that these are on sale, super helpful. So 25% off and an additional 10. I know that Chantecaille does 30% off their website, maybe 1 or 2 times a year, but if you shop on the Skin Store site, it's 25 plus the 10, so it is over 30%. So these are my favorite ones. They're the ones that have the black and white photos of animals. And Chantecaille is a brand where all of their products, the proceeds, or a portion of the proceeds go towards wildlife preservation. So this one is in, this is called Burnished Brown, and this is a, has the giraffe on it. These are so beautiful, and this is what I have on my lids today and just really blended everywhere. It is the type of shadow where if you apply it with your finger, it's very shimmery, and if you blend it with a brush, it performs like a matte, as in like it blends like a matte, so you can get like a really beautiful soft finish. This next one is Sophisticated Olive. I use this one the most. I just really wanted to do a warm eye today, so I went for the Burnished Brown. But this is my most used of them because it's like this olivey, slightly taupey shade. This is Dusky Lilac and it has the pangolin on it. It's just, they're so cute. And the last one I have is called Shimmering Taupe Gray. So it has an elephant on it and just so beautiful. Baked Gelée here is just done so perfectly. Well, those are swatches, so that's the bronzer that I kind of have in the crease and on the lower lash line, and those are all of the swatches. So Burnished Brown, the Olive, the Dusky Lilac, and the Shimmering Taupe Gray. They've come out with 2 new shades. One of them is like a burgundy shade that I'm probably likely going to pick up, and then there's a rose gold type color. I don't know. I'm so glad they've expanded on this line because they're so beautiful. Just as like an extra aside here, these are the mermaid eye colors. So in last week's video, I wore Starfish and I wore it by itself. I didn't put anything else with it. And it looked so pretty. I thought it looked very like shadowy and shimmery in a really beautifully balanced way. Like I love that eye look. Another shade that I like a lot is called Sylvie, and it is kind of a neutral tone, but because it reflects light, I don't know how to explain to you how these reflect light, because they're not metallic. They're like soft shimmer, and then depending on how the light hits it, they will look matte and shimmery at the same time with the same color. And this is like not to tease you, but just to make you excited about Chantecaille. This is the mermaid eye color in Lagoon. This was limited edition. It is so beautiful. Okay, so those are swatches. So Starfish is what I had on last week. It can look very dark and very like reflective. And then that's Sylvie. Sylvie, when I put it on, it looks very light on the lid and dark in the crease. So it's like, these are all like one shade eyeshadows, and it's because of the formula. And this last one is Lagoon. I mean, so pretty. So for eyeliner, I have the DHC liquid liner. This is made in Japan, one of my favorite liquid liners. This one I actually had trouble using today because I have a backup and I just can't find it, but we still managed. I think these lashes with this, the way the liner is, like the direction of the liner, it's like on point today. Last but not least are the lips, and this is the natural lip definer. This is a really, well, I don't know. I wouldn't say that this shade is something that I would typically go for. And these two items are also ones that I had sent to me. And the Lip Chic is in Sari Rose. I had another Lip Chic before, and it was like this really pretty orangey shade, and I cannot find it. I feel like I put it in a purse or a pocket, and now it's out in the world. I was so sad. It was my first Chantecaille lip product. So those are swatches. Ignore, we have a little bit of eyeshadow residue, but that's the lip liner, and that is the Sari Rose Lip Chic. So next up is a little mini grocery haul for you guys.
Okay, Aldi haul. Turkey stuffing, wavy potato chips. Sodium is 9%. This might be an obvious regretful purchase, but I really wanted to taste the flavor. Two of these quinoa puffs, the yogurt cucumber, so good, must have repurchased. Also repurchased these wafer crackers, two cracked pepper, and two sesame. Oh, so good. Smoked white cheddar. This street corn dip. We have roasted corn, cilantro, red chili, mayo, sour cream, Monterey Jack, cotija, and I can't pronounce that one. Neuchâtel. Whatever. Repurchase. These, I showed you, yeah, last week. So good. There's also a brownie version. Also excited. This is new. Cheese and dill salmon Wellington. Looks amaze. I love dill. Shrimp and white wine, salmon, Wellington, excite. Chicken for Sumo, salmon for me, and dozen eggs.
All right, I'm gonna update you guys on some skincare, remind you of some things that I still really love and other things I've tried. So I've jumped on the Obagi train. It's been months now, maybe, yeah, maybe since, I mean, it's definitely like later this year. So we started off loving the Obagi Retinol 1.0. There is a 0.5 if you feel that you are particularly sensitive, if you've never used a retinol before, but I love this one. It is quite gentle as far as like, I have been able to wear it consecutively, probably 3-4 nights, as long as I top it with a moisturizer. There's no peeling, but there's definitely a beautiful result. The results that you want will be much slower, and it is done without the peeling. But I love this. It has your typical kind of yellowy tone to it, which blends right into your skin. So in the beginning, I used it every other night, and I was like, well, I'm not really reacting badly to it. So I started using it every night consecutively, and I'll like dip into this when it's like, I feel like my skin just needs like a refresher, but like a subtle refresh, not like I want to peel, I want to be dry, that kind of thing. The next item that I decided to try out was the Obagi Hydrate Luxe, and I've already shared this with you probably in a haul, but I really love this. I didn't think, based off of the texture, it was something I would be super into. I am someone that likes a creamy cream, you know, and this looks a little more solid. It kind of feels like the way a body butter would feel. So I actually have this on today, and I brought it up to my under eyes. So I don't know which school of thought I necessarily ascribe to when it comes to eye cream. I buy eye creams because I like them. I feel like I see a difference when I use them when I need them, i.e. if I'm feeling quite dry, if I feel like the under eye wrinkles or fine lines are more apparent. And overall, in general, to maintain hydration, to add hydration, I think that eye creams make a huge difference. However, This is something, there's probably only a hand, not even a handful. I'm trying to think, maybe three-ish moisturizers that I use on my face that I also bring up to my eyes and then we'll skip an eye cream. And so far, this is definitely one of them. I apply this and I think that it's something that won't sink in only because of the texture that I'm like used to, which is like a little like smoother. Not that this isn't smooth, but like you saw, it's more like not quite a balm, somewhere between a balm and a cream. And it just absorbs immediately, it hydrates really, really well. But it doesn't leave you greasy. So if that's kind of what you're looking for, you will absolutely love this. Do not go off of my like shiny skin here. This is not this, that's how my skin is. So been loving this face and eyes. I recently mentioned the Obagi Physical Defense Tinted Sunscreen with SPF 50 PA 4 pluses. And I mentioned how much product you're getting in here. You are getting a substantial amount of product. You're getting 3.4 ounces here. So it's a lot, but on top of that, it is quite watery. So I mentioned that I would put it into a cushion compact, and here it is. It's not it is kind of like I said, a watery consistency, like very watery. So that's the tone of it. It is neutral to warm. I don't think it's cool at all. If you have a cool skin tone, I have something else to recommend to you. Okay, so there's the finish. It is rather glowy, but it does settle, and once you add powder and a little bit of concealer, you can really achieve that like no makeup makeup look. So if you are someone that is more cool toned or neutral, I would recommend this Hydropeptide to you. I picked it up because, you know, I want to try every tinted sunscreen or anything with SPF 50. The color of this product is white, so it's supposed to color adjust. Now, it does do that, but I feel like on my skin, it color adjusts to something more beige slash more cool toned. So here's what it looks like. It's a white product. And as you blend it in, oh, and it has a really beautiful like skincare scent. The other one doesn't have, the Obagi doesn't really have a scent to it. So this, as you can see, it's finishing off a little cool on my skin. It is glowy now, but this one mattifies down, at least on my skin. So I don't use this that often because it does dry to make me look kind of pink and beige, which I don't like. I do not know if this is going to be obvious. This is the Obagi and this is the Hydropeptide. So the Obagi is definitely glowier. This one has kind of settled down into like a skin-like finish. Okay, continuing on the Obagi train. So I feel like every time I talk about Obagi, I add like one extra product that I haven't talked about before, because Obagi is something you need to go into slowly. I mean, it's expensive. So these are, okay, this is one of the products I saw early on and was like, at some point I will get this. And it's the Daily Hydro Drops. I mean, look how beautiful. There's little droplets, the yellow in there, they're like individual little beads that break apart when you apply it. So it says that it's formulated with vitamin B3 and hibiscus oil. I was reading about this product and it said to use this as the last step after you've applied your serum and moisturizer, etc. It's not meant to be a moisturizing, like the only moisturizer you use. However, I have like normal dry skin. I did use it accordingly and it created this very humectant-y effect on my skin, which I like for winter and when it's colder. But I also decided to use it on its own as a moisturizer, and it was still incredibly hydrating and moisturizing. You still got remnants of that like humectant feel on your skin. So I don't think if you have oily skin, even if it does work for your skin, you might not enjoy the feeling of it because you can feel the moisture being like, what's the word? Being trapped on your skin. So I like that feeling, especially in the winter. I have used it under makeup. It also looks really good there. So I've been testing this out for maybe like a week and a half on and off, like sometimes using it at night, sometimes using it during the day. And I'm here to report that I really, really enjoy this. But again, this is not like the only hydrator, but I think if you suffer from really dry skin, introducing something like this into your skincare regimen or just to kind of seal off your moisture, it is transformative in that it holds everything in without it sloughing off. Cause sometimes when I apply like multiple layers of moisturizer in the morning, I get like peelies, which I don't mind, but I just feel like it's been like sitting on top of my skin. With this, I don't experience that. Okay, next up is Derma Doctor. And Derma Doctor, I've mentioned two of their products to you, I think. Maybe I've mentioned all three, but I have revisited this because I was using the PCA skin tint for the eyes, and this is the DDI Derma Doctor. This is actually my first experience with a tinted under eye cream that also has an SPF. This has SPF 30. And I shared this with you, I think I was going through kind of a phase. I was talking about Color Science, their under eye with SPF. Okay, now you can really see. The left-hand side has gone quite a little orange pinky. And then this is still maintaining, you know, it matches my skin tone better. But again, glowy. Okay, so I'm gonna swatch it on the... I feel like you guys have to be more annoyed than I am every time I'm adjusting my hair, but something happens where the hair just starts collecting in here, and I feel like I have like a hairy chest or something when I like randomly glance at the viewfinder. So anyway, I'm gonna swatch the Derma Doctor, this like DDI on the Obagi side because it's closer to my skin tone. And it definitely has a peachiness to it. It isn't enough to color correct some very dark eye circles, but it's enough to give your under eye a bit of a tint. So I know you're supposed to finish everything off with SPF, it should be the last step, but when it comes to SPF under eye creams, because I haven't found one that is extremely like hydrating enough for me, I tend to put these down first and then I'll go over it with like a different eye cream. All right, so last week I mentioned that I was using something to peel my skin. Maskne, once it is gone, you are left with dark spots, and I have had a good amount. Today, I have a very, very low coverage foundation on. What do I have on? The Shantikai Future Skin? No, yes, the Shantikai Future Skin. And there's no concealer, so you can definitely see my dark spots. But if I did not have those, this foundation would be very skin-like and beautiful on me. So my fading product of choice is usually a vitamin C type product. So these I have had in my collection, I say collection, when I talk about skincare, for a long time, only because I use them very sporadically and because the way I use them, it's quite potent. So if you are familiar with the Dr. Dennis Gross peel pads, they have two towelettes. You apply one and then after a few minutes, you use the other one to take it off and to bring your pH back to like a normal stable state, yeah? So these are the same, but you get one pad and you're supposed to apply it, and after 2-3 minutes, you're supposed to rinse it off. I would do that sometimes, but I decided to test it out where I don't rinse it off. The first time, I did not even know what happened, right? Because I forgot that I just like left this on overnight. Yeah, don't use this during the day either, use this at night. So I applied it, woke up the next morning, you know, I like, you know, cleanse my face and like put on moisturizer as usual. By midday, and then definitely by the end of the day, the amount of peeling that was happening. And then the day after, there is more peeling. So I would say with this, if you leave it on overnight, 2 to 3 days of peeling. So if you're going to do that, definitely try it on a weekend. You know, I mean, it's up to you, because I feel like this has the potential to burn your skin a little bit. So not in like the burn, like tingling, like burn, like you will keep feeling it, like that kind of a burn, like when you've had something spicy, that kind of, you know? Also, if you are going to do this, any kind of peeling type product, this retinol, glycolic acid, wear sunscreen during the day to protect your skin, because your skin is vulnerable. The barrier has been compromised. Did I even tell you what these are? I keep showing it to you. So it's the Intensive Vitamin C Peel Pad with Ferulic Acid and Vitamin E. So this is the size of a pad. This is the one I used last week. I decided to keep it so I can show you guys one without me opening a new one. So the pad is quite large. You could potentially save half of it to use later, but you'd have to seal it in like a baggie or something. I've done that before, but you get a lot of product in this. It's not sopping wet, but it's a generous amount of product and it is very effective. If you want something more gentle, this is the same thing, but it's in a liquid form. And I feel like there's like kind of like a very hydrating almost like an oil type base to this. So when I apply this, I use this the way I would almost use like a retinol. So I cleanse my face at night, apply this, and I put moisturizer on top of it. And it has very similar effects to retinol for me, but because of the vitamin C in there, I also get that good kind of like slow fade of blemish, you know, what do you call them? Like dark spots. Okay, so that is it for this little clip. Like I mentioned, I'm testing out the Replenix, and I will report later on in the video for you guys.
Okay, so we've ordered some Indian food. This is a place I've ordered from before, and it's the only place I've ordered from twice. So basically every time I get Malai Kofta, and this one has been the tastiest out of all the ones I've tried. I've probably ordered from four different places at this point. This is my favorite. I got the Pani Puri again. We have the filling. And then the sauce. And then this is the naan that came with the Malai Kofta. I obviously prefer the basmati rice. I did not want to spend for that. What was my promo here? I think it was like 7 off 20. Yes, for Uber Eats. And then this is an aloo cheese paratha. So potato cheese stuffed inside there is going to be very delicious. I'm very excited. Okay, so this is another random share, but I picked these up off of Amazon. I love double wall mugs, double wall glasses. So this one kind of serves the purpose of both. It's, I think, 12 ounces, but I've been testing it out. Yes, I test drinkware out because in case I don't like it, I only have like, you know, used one, but it says 12 ounces. I feel like it actually only holds like 8 to 10. So it's very pretty. It's like beveled on the outside, faceted. And then the inside is just like a regular, I don't know, what do you call it, interior. So we're going wild right now and we're having a cream soda. So very cute, yeah? There, I'm holding up to my TV so you can kind of see what it looks like. Very pretty.
So, Replenix is a brand that I see on a lot of skincare websites. The reviews are always quite positive, and I don't know why I've never tried. Actually, I do know why. I haven't really tried it because it's not like a brand I hear about a lot. So I showed these four products to you in last week's vlog to let you know that I'm going to be testing them out. So the basis for this line is green tea polyphenol. There's polyphenol, polyphenol. I think it's a matter of British English versus American English. I don't know which one I'm most comfortable with. I might dip back and forth between the two pronunciations, but I have some notes here because when I talk about a lot of products, glycolic acid, retinol, vitamin C, like it's very easy for me to talk about it because I have like a reference point for it. When it comes to the basis for this line, which is green tea polyphenol, I didn't know very much about it, so I wanted to read up so I could talk to you guys about it in like a somewhat educated manner. So what they do, I have like notes here. So basically, these are plant-derived antioxidants. So a lot of skincare brands use it as a basis for their entire brand or for a line within their brand. So we've seen a lot of this. This is not anything new, but green tea is interesting to me. I feel like I typically see green tea in Korean skincare and Japanese skincare often, and less so in the West. It's essentially an antioxidant, fights free radicals, it helps repair DNA damage by promoting DNA repair. So basically, it helps your sun damage. It helps to repair your sun damage. It reduces sebum, which fights acne. It increases and retains moisture. It can reduce swelling and puffiness, which makes sense because oftentimes we will use green tea bags over our eyes or even on our entire face as a depuffer. It also protects against UV radiation. So again, sun. So the first item I'm gonna talk about, because I have a fully formed opinion about this, is the Replenix All Trans Retinol Enriched Eye Repair Cream with niacinamide, hyaluronic acid, ceramides, green tea polyphenols, phenols, and peptides. So I have tried so many retinol eye creams, and I try them because retinol is in them. However, I never find them hydrating enough. I always top it off with a very hydrating eye cream or eye moisturizer. This one, I can actually use it on its own. I've used it 3-4 times. First night, I did not top it off, and it worked beautifully. It was still very hydrated in the morning. It's not hydrating in that you'll have like a very emollient eye the next morning, but it's hydrating in that it doesn't dry out your under eye. So I am very happy to find an retinol eye cream that actually I can use it alone without topping it off, without, you know, layering or sealing moisture in. Like, it works all in one. And I love a lot of their components. You just, so easy. Like, one of my favorite types of like packaging. Next up is the Replenix 3x Retinol Forte Micropolymer Delivery System. This has 90% green tea polyphenols, and I believe a lot of their products in the lineup are 90% green tea polyphenols. So this, I am no stranger to retinol. I have not used one like this before. First of all, there is a lot of dimethicone in here. I'm not really sure about why there are so many. There's probably 8 different kinds of dimethicone type, silicone type products in here. And usually those kind of clog up my skin, but this did not do that. Like, I wore it and I did not feel that way, nor did I get any bumps from this. And I usually get bumps quite quickly, so I'll know to remove the item from my skincare regimen. But this doesn't do that. It also kind of has that like yellowy color. So the texture looks like that, which looks pretty standard for a retinol product. It's a little yellow in tone. And when you blend it out, it literally feels exactly the way a silicone primer feels. And at first I did not like it, especially on my skin. I was like blending it and I was like, weird. But then the second I blended it in, it was fine. Like, everything felt fine. And I put a moisturizer on top of it and I went to bed and everything was like business as usual. So I think it was just more of like a something to get used to. This is a very easy, casual retinol to use. So I didn't know this before going into it, but I purchased the 3x retinol. There's a 5x and a 10x, and I just didn't realize. Otherwise, I might have picked up something stronger, because this performs very similar to the way the Obagi retinol that I have showed you performs. It's this whole line pairs really well with sensitive skin. You're not gonna see, I was reading so many reviews and so many of them were like, I didn't have peeling, it wasn't sensitive, it didn't cause inflammation. And I'm like, this sounds really great, you know, for people with sensitive skin. This one is just their Soothing Antioxidant Mist. And I think I just picked it up because I've been really into mist lately. This mist goes on really beautifully. I love the way it mists. And it just smells and feels very like, kind of, like medicinal, but like, not in like a stingy way. So the main ingredient is purified water. Further, just a tiny bit further down the list is witch hazel. And then you have, you know, green tea extract and ascorbic acid, which is vitamin C. So I am someone who has purchased witch hazel, like, you know, like in a bottle, but you have to put it on a cotton pad. And I'm just like so lazy about it because I really enjoy witch hazel as a product. But will I spray it on my face? Absolutely. This is the Replenix Acne Solutions Acne Gel Benzoyl Peroxide 10%. There is also a 2.5 and there's also a 5. Whenever I'm looking for a benzoyl peroxide, I just go for the 10. It's just what I've done. Even though I know that, similar to sunscreen, the 10% versus the 5%, I don't know that there's a huge difference. So like with sunscreen, I think anything beyond SPF 30, the difference is very marginal. So, I mean, I know, but I get the 10%. So a couple nights ago, in general, with masks and everything, I have been getting bumps, blemishes, but the blemishes seem to occur more here. And then I'll get like just like bumps and textures. Sometimes they're really, really tiny zits, you know what I mean? So I took this. This is definitely like a paste. This is not one of those like smooth, luxurious experiences. It is kind of chalky and kind of a bit of a paste. So this is not something that I recommend you use during the day. Even if you don't wear makeup, because it will leave like a white chalky look on your face. I took this, let me show you a little bit. This is a generous amount of product. So it's just a white gel, but it is kind of gritty. It doesn't look gritty on camera because it's hard for me to show you
exactly
that much that I showed you. And I ran it right along my chin area, like a little bit along the contour of it and a little bit below, because that's just where I was experiencing a lot of texture. The next morning, I woke up. There was like nothing. All the texture was absolutely gone. I had a little spot up here that I didn't get all the way up here, so I still had that like bump there, but everything else was gone. I was like, this is magical. This is my new best friend. I am keeping this front and center on my skincare vanity. Like, this is so good. After reading so much about green tea polyphenols, I'm so interested. So if you are also interested, the Replenix products are 30% off with an additional 10% off with the code GEN10. Okay guys, so closing out this video, everything will be linked below with its percentage off as well as the additional 10% off code for you. This video was easily over an hour long. I really tried to edit it down without taking out all the like important information as far as the reviews go. So hopefully it's helpful to you. My goal is to have another video up this weekend with items that I've received from Black Friday sales already and or sales that I'm going to be shopping from or am interested in. So look out for that and happy Thanksgiving, and I will see you later this weekend.